Good morning to you. Today we'll be talking about polynomial of a function.
Polynomial, as I'm stated here, we have a poly and a nomial.
Poly generally means more than one, that is two or more.
Why nomial? From the term
nomia, simply means term itself.
So a polynomial f of x is defined as a x r to the power n plus b x r to the power n minus 1 plus c x r to the power n minus 2 plus the last term q. Now, when the highest power of n here is 1, the polynomial is being observed to be a linear function a x plus b, and we call this a linear function. When the highest power of n is 2, the polynomial is then observed to be a quadratic function, whereby we have a x squared plus b x plus c. Observe something here. If you impute 1 here, you have 1. 1 minus 1 is equal to 0, so all other terms are neglected. Why? Same thing applies to n equal to 2. Impute 2 here. Impute 2 here, and all other terms are neglected. Why? If your n equal to 3, you have your f of x to be a cubic function. Same thing applicable when your n is 4. You have your f of x to be a quadratic function. This is the word quadratic function. And when your n is also 5, you have your f of x to be a quintic function. Sometimes it's usually represented as quintic function. Now when your n is also 6, you still have something like this, but the highest power of n must be what? 6 plus the other terms. Here we have a sextic function. Do you observe anything? That this is a combination of two terms. Term 1, term 2. Hence, we call it a polynomial function. This combines 3 terms 1, 2, 3. And this has 1, 2, 3, 4. And this has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, the highest power of n here is 1. Hence, it's called a linear function. N here is what? 2. We call it a quadratic function. Where n is 3, we call it a cubic function. And so on. Now, there are general methods of solving polynomials, and we combine polynomials the way we combine numbers. The way we say 2 plus 2 is 4, that is the way we combine polynomials also. We perform some basic operations such as additions, subtractions, divisions, and multiplications, and the main operations of numbers, which includes this, and this, have been performed on polynomials with function. Generally, we can solve and find the general root of a linear function. We can find the general root of a quadratic function. We can also find the general root of a cubic function. We can find the general root of a quadratic function, but we can't find the general root. We can't find the general root of. This is meant for this.
this is meant for this, this is meant for this, this is meant for this. Now we can find general root of a quadratic function, but we can't find general root of a quintic function because of Abel's impossible theorems, which was stated with Gallius. It says it is impossible to find the general root of a polynomial with degree n greater than or equal to 5. That is, when n is 5, we can't find the general root of this function. Now, the general root of a linear function can easily be gotten if our ax plus b is equal to 0, our x is simply minus b over a. Now, for a quadratic function, general formula can also be gotten if our ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, our x is minus b plus or minus the square root of b squared, minus 4ac over 2a. Now, for a cubic function also, general formula can also be gotten, but I would love to prove that, because cramming is bad for your health. Now, if ax cubed plus bx squared plus cx plus d is equal to 0, then our x will be equal to what? Now, from here, I'll make some nice substitutions. Let x equal to y minus b over 3 from here. Now, if we substitute this into this expression, you will observe something. This stuff breaks down to y cubed plus py plus q equals to 0. This is called a reduced cubic form. Now, a reduced cubic form of this nature simply means two things. But before that, we observe we have pa, that is in y cube plus on py plus q equals to 0. Our p, in terms of the coefficient here, is of c minus b, b squared over 3, and our q is of d minus bc over 3 plus 2bq over 27. Y from here, we make another substitution. Let y equal to z minus p over 3z. If you make this substitution into this expression here, you have z cubed equal to minus q over 2 plus root r. Where this r means q over 2 all squared plus p over 3 all cubed. Now, by substituting each and every one of them into the expression, that is, initially, once we know our coefficient of b, we can find that of x in terms of y. Then we can find y in terms of x. Then we have this. Then by making the following substitutions, we arrive at a general formula. A general formula in the sense that what? This z cube simply means z equal to the cube root of minus q over 2 plus root. This r is q over 2 all squared plus p over 3 all q. Now, this stuff here can be imputed into this expression here, such that your y becomes the cube root of minus q over 2 plus root q over 2 all squared plus p over 3 all q minus p over, you repeat the same expression here. Let me rewrite it because of the board. P over 2 all squared plus P over 3 all Q. Good, good. Minus P divided by cube root of minus Q over 2 plus root Q over 2 all squared plus on P over 3 all Q. That is, this is our value for y, which can also be substituted here to get our x. As the general formula for x becomes y, which is on the cube root of minus q over 2 plus root q over 2 all squared plus p over 3 all cubed minus p divided by the cube root of minus q over 2 plus root q over 2 all squared plus 2 over 3 all cubed.
This expression here, our P is this, don't forget. And our Q is this. This expression here simply known as the Cardano's formula. The Cardano's formula. Now this expression here can be proven using some other method. That is, it is possible to get the general root of a cubic function, just the way we get the general root of a quadratic function using this formula. You can also get out of a cubic function without doing any calculation using this formula, provided we substitute our Q to be this and our P to be this. We also have some other method, but because of our time, I would like to move on to the addition, subtraction, multiplication, and divisions of polynomials. And we also have that of quartic function, that is degree of 4. I'll be showing how we can get the general formula of a quartic function in our next class. But for now, let me show how we deal with additions of polynomial. We are familiar with additions of polynomial. Now, given f of x equal to 2x cubed plus 4x squared plus 6x plus 5, and g of x is 7x raised to the power 5 plus 2x squared plus x minus 5. Now, f of x plus g of x can be added by adding terms with same powers together. Now look at it, this is 2x cubed, this is 7x raised to the power 5. Now we don't have same power of such here. Hence, we take this 7x raised to the power 5 plus, now the next power is power 4. This is reduced 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. But we don't have a power 4 time here. Then we move on to the next power 3, that is 2x cubed plus, the next time is the next power 2, that is 4x squared, will be added to what? 2x squared. So 4x squared plus 2x squared is what? 6x squared. The next one is what? The power 1. 6x plus x. 7x. Then you have 5 minus 5, which is 0. This is how to add polynomials. So we also have subtractions of polynomials, which will be done in the same pattern or same manner. F of x minus g of x, you have this minus this minus 7x raised to the power 5. You don't have a power of 5 here, so subtracting from this one, you have minus of this. The next one is 4, none of them. The next one is 3, so 2x cubed minus, none of them has power 3, so we have 2x cubed. The next one is power 2, 4x squared minus, this is 4x squared minus 2x squared here, which is what? 2x squared. Next one is the constant, the power 1 term here. We have 6x minus x, which is what? 5x. And 5 minus 5, which is what? 10. This is how we subtract polynomials. Now, the next one is the multiplication of polynomials. They are very complex functions, complex in terms of their terms arrangement, and complex in terms of their multiplication format. What am I talking about? Now, let us look at this. Given f of x is 2x squared plus 3x plus 1, and g of x is 3x squared plus x minus 2. Now, f of x times g of x can be done in just a straight line using several methods. We have this times this becomes this times this, 6x to the power 4, 2, 9, 11x cubed minus 4, 3, minus 1, 2x squared minus 6 plus 3. Minus 3x minus 6 plus 1 minus 5x and minus 2.
in just a single term, you can expand a trinomial with a trinomial. You can go to the long method to check if this is actually on point. So which is on point? So all of this is very simple, provided you watch me carefully. Now look at, in expanding a polynomial function, in expanding any polynomial function, if you want to multiply a monomial with a monomial, that is a one-time expression like 2x with 3x, we know it's very easy, isn't it? You have 6x squared. Now, you want to multiply a binomial with a binomial. That is also quite easy, like 2x plus 3, like 2x plus 3 times 4x plus 5. The first thing we do when multiplying a binomial with a binomial is to take the first term and the first term together. 2x times 4x is 8x squared, isn't it? Now, you have 2x times 5, that's 10x, plus, keep that 10x somewhere, plus 3 times 4x. Now this is 10x plus 12x becomes 22x. Now 3 times this last term here, 5, you have 15. That is how you multiply binomials by binomials. Now I want to multiply a binomial with a trinomial in just a single line. What do I mean by that? You have 2x squared plus 3x plus 1 times x plus 2. Now, the first thing we do is to multiply the first term of the expression here. That is 2x squared times x becomes 2x cubed. Now, we take these two terms and these two terms together. We have 4x squared, that is this times this, becomes 4x squared. Keep 4x squared somewhere. This times this, that's 3x squared. That is 4x squared. This is 4x squared plus 3x squared, which is what? 7x squared. The next one, we take this term and this term. You know, we pick the first two term here and the first two term here. The next thing we do is to pick the last two term and the first two term again. Now we have 3x times 2 is 6x. Keep 6x somewhere in your mind. 1 times x is x. That's 6x plus x is what? 7x. Isn't it? The next one, you multiply the last term with the last term. 1 times 2 is what? 2. That is how to multiply a trinomial with a binomial in just split seconds. We practice to be able to multiply such expression like this in just 5 seconds. Now, moving on to the grand trinomial, the trinomial with the trinomial. Given an expression of this format, 2x squared plus 3x plus 1 multiplied by 3x squared plus x minus 2. Now, the first thing we do is multiply the first term with the first term of the expression here. That is 2x squared times 3x squared becomes 6x raised to the power 4, right? The next thing we do is multiply the first two term with the first two term. How? 2x squared times x is 3x squared, isn't it? You keep 3x cubed, rather, in your mind. 3x, you know, this is this times this plus this times this. Now, 3x times 3x squared is what? 9x raised to the power 3. That is, when added together, you have what? 11x cubed. Now, the next thing is to multiply. We are looking for the power 2. You multiply this by this, that is, 2x squared times minus 2, you have minus 4x squared. Plus this times this, that is minus 4x squared plus 3x squared is minus x squared. This times this, that is minus x squared plus 3x squared becomes plus 2x squared. Now the next one is what? To multiply these two terms with these two terms. 3x times minus 2 is minus 6. This times this, that is minus 6 plus x. That's minus 5x. The next is multiply this last term with this last term. 1 times minus 2 is what? Minus 2. That is how to multiply a trinomial with a trinomial in just 5 seconds or less, based on your practice. Now, in general now, to multiply functions. Functions in terms of what? In different order. You know, we're able to do this because of we have power of 3, 1, 0, and same power. Now, if we were to multiply stuff like this, if we have f of x equal to 2x raised to the power 4, plus 3x squared minus x plus 1 times 6x raised to the power 7 plus x raised to the power 4 minus 2x cubed plus 5x plus 6. I'm going to multiply this kind of stuff now. Originally, we can multiply each of them out, then this, multiply by this, then we do it. That's just long thing. Although we are going to arrive at our answer, but in mathematics, speed and accuracy is the order of the game here. So in order to get this function, we're going to use of a latex multiplication theorem, which says you multiply this term with all this term and you list them here up. 2x to the power 4 times this power here. That is 3x to the power 4 times 6x to the power 7 becomes 12x raised to the power 11. This times this, isn't it? Now the next thing is to multiply this with this. That is, you're using this to multiply each term here, or all terms rather. Now 2x raised to the power 4 times x to the power 4 becomes what? 2x raised to the power 8. Times this, you have minus 6x raised to the power 7. You have plus 10x raised to the power 5. That's plus 12x raised to the power 4. That is how we do this. Let me rewrite it here because of our space. 12x raised to the power 7 plus 2x raised to the power 8 minus 4x raised to the power 7 plus 10x raised to the power 5 plus 12x raised to the power 4. That is this times this. Now the next one is multiply this term with this term here. You have 3x squared times 6x raised to the power 7 here. 3x squared times 6x raised to the power 7 is what? 18x raised to the power 9. Did you observe anything here that we don't have power 9 here? This is raised to the power 11. Now we don't have power 9 here, isn't it? So the next thing we do is to position this expansion. This is 12x to the power 11, 0x to the power 10, 0x to the power 9. Now this time this is 2x to the power 8 minus 4x to the power 7 and 10x to the power 5 plus 12x to the power 4. Now the next one is taking. This is 7, we need 0x to the power 6 plus 10x to the power 5 plus 12x to the power 4. The next thing we do now is to multiply this with everything again, that is 3x squared with 6x to the power 7. So you have 3x squared with this is 18x to the power 9. Then you have 18x to the power 9. This times this is 3x to the power 6. 6 times this is what? 15x cubed. Right? That's 15x cubed. This times this is 18x squared. Now, you don't need to put all these 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Just because of some certain condition, so you can just leave it there. Now, minus x times all of this also, we do the same thing. Minus x times this is minus 6x to the power 8. Minus x times this is minus x to the power 5. Minus x times this is plus 2x to the power 4. This is minus 5x squared and minus 6x. So the same thing the last time here, just the last time is just 6x to the power 5, this is to the power 7, plus x to the power 4, minus 2x cubed, plus 5x, minus plus 6. So this time here, you now carefully arrange them such that the last time the 6 comes down, the other times you multiply them by the coefficient. Continue next class.